Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about the ColourPop Pressed Powder Eyeshadow Palettes. There are four palettes available, and I don't think I've done like an extensive review or really talked about them on my channel a whole lot other than the ColourPop My Little Pony palette. I do have a review of this one, and I did use it in a Get Ready With Me, so I'll link them in the description box below if you guys are interested. But I get a lot of questions on these palettes, just my thoughts on them, which ones I would recommend, which ones I like best, and I thought I would go ahead and do an overview, some swatches, and just kind of chat about them with you guys. So I hope you enjoy this video. Let's jump into it. If you want to jump ahead, because there are four different palettes, I'll put timestamps in the description box below so you don't have to listen to the entire video if you're only interested in one or two of them, but let's jump into it. So all of these palettes are currently available on the ColourPop website. Two of them are limited edition, as far as I believe. I know the My Little Pony palette is definitely limited edition, and I think the She palette is limited edition because it was part of a collab, and usually those are not permanent, but the I Think I Love You palette and the Yes Please palette seem to be permanent palettes, at least for now. They always discontinue their products, so it's hard to know for sure. They each come with 16 different eyeshadows. The eyeshadow pans are a little bit smaller than the single ColourPop pressed powder shadows. Not by a whole lot, by a little bit, but it is such a good value. I broke it down, you know, per gram in one of my previous videos. I'll put that information on the screen for you guys so you know for sure. The packaging is cardboard packaging, and on the back they have a sticker with all of the shades in each of the palettes. The pan sizes are smaller than traditional pans, but I don't have any issue, you know, using my brush in them, whether it's a flat shader brush or a fluffy crease brush, or even using my finger to pack the color onto the lid. If you guys are not familiar with the ColourPop pressed powder shadow formula, it is one of my favorites. These shadows in these palettes are the same exact formula as the single shadows, so there's not really a variation. They perform exactly the same, which is definitely a plus in my opinion, because sometimes when you create a shadow palette versus a single shadow, the quality is diminished, but that's not the case with these palettes at all. There are three different finishes. The first one is a matte finish, which is very smooth and blendable and pigmented. It's my favorite matte formula because it is so blendable and so easy to use. When you dip your brush into the shadow, you are going to get a lot of powder kick up, so just keep that in mind. If that's something that bothers you, you're not going to like these matte shadows, but I don't have any fallout once they're on the eyes. They blend beautifully and they're very easy to use. The metallic finish is equally as beautiful. It's very pigmented. It goes on the eyes so beautifully. I personally find that I get the best result when I pack it on with a finger, but you could use like a flat shader brush. ColourPop makes a really great one. I would say out of the three finishes, the satin finish is probably my least favorite. It's a little bit more on the subtle side. They're kind of like a less intense or pigmented or glittery version of the metallic shadows. So some people like a more natural shimmer, so that might appeal to you, but the palettes consist mainly of metallics and mattes with like one or two shimmers thrown in. So honestly, in my opinion, $16 is a great deal for these palettes. They are a little bit on the smaller side, but for $16, you really can't beat it. You get a bunch of different shades, and they are very, very high quality. So that's just like a quick rundown on my thoughts of the actual quality. And I find that, you know, the quality is similar throughout the four palettes. I don't feel like one palette is a lot lesser quality than the other ones. So let me start with this one. This is the one that I'm actually wearing on my eyes today. It's called the She Palette. It was part of the Femme Rosa collaboration. So I do think that this one will eventually be discontinued, because anytime they do a collaboration, the products are limited edition. So if you're interested in this one, I would recommend grabbing it. The packaging on this one is my favorite. It's very beautiful. It's floral and red and purple, and it has like metallic rose gold writing. I kind of feel like this one's an underrated palette. It is so beautiful. Like everything from the packaging to the shades to the formula are really, really gorgeous. And I feel like a lot of people overlook this palette, but I definitely would recommend giving it a second look if you're one of those people that kind of overlooked it the first time. I did. It took me a little while to buy it, but as soon as I bought it and I started using it, I honestly fell in love with it. So this palette has four mattes, seven metallics, and one satin. I like the way that this palette is laid out. I feel like it's the most cohesive out of all of the palettes, because you get your row of highlight shades, your row of lid shades, and then your row of crease shades. Of course, you can mix and match them however you want, but to me, when I look at this palette, it makes the most sense and I know what I'm going to do on my eyes. If you are a fan of rosy tones like pinks and purples, this is going to be a great palette for you. There are a lot of cooler tone shadows in here, but I feel like there are some warm shadows kind of mixed in. The crease shades are gorgeous, and I feel like you can get a ton of different looks out of this palette because there is good variation between the matte shadows. So a lot of times I use mattes in the crease as transitions in the outer corner, but I feel like there is a good amount of variation. I mean, I can get a couple complete eye looks using this palette alone. The only thing that I think it's missing is like a matte white highlight, but for the price, I mean, you're not going to get every single color you need for a complete eye look in it. But I really do feel like this one is the underrated palette. If you think at all that you enjoy purples or pinks, I think you'll really like it. I think that my favorite out of the four is the I Think I Love You palette. It comes in this really gorgeous copper packaging, and this one comes with 8 metallics and 4 mattes. There are no shimmers in here, and I feel like this one is the most neutral in my opinion. It comes with some great crease colors, some great transitions. You do have a matte brow bone highlight, and then you also have a matte black, which I think a lot of people love in palettes. I think the other two matte shadows are really nice. You get this cooler toned brown and then this warmer toned brown, so I can use either one of those as crease colors, and then the actual metallic shadows look beautiful with all of the other matte shadows. I said that the Femrosa palette is the most cohesive in terms of the way that it's laid out. It makes the most sense to me, but I think the I Think I Love You palette is the most cohesive in terms of the actual shadows, because I feel like you can get a lot of looks out of this palette. The matte shadows go really well together. They're everything that you need for a complete look, and then they go really well with the metallic shadows in the palette as well. You have highlight shades, you have lid shades, you have outer corner shades. It's just an all-around well-rounded palette. I think you could use this for a really nice, easy go-to everyday look, but you can also use it for more of like a going out sultry eye look as well. And then there are some in-betweens. This is the palette that I reach for the most often. If you like bronze tones or you like, you know, just neutral eye looks, this is going to be a great option for you. There are a few pops of more colorful shadows in the palette, but in general, it leans very neutral and very bronzy. So I just really enjoy this palette. Let's talk about the Yes Please palette. This one is the first one that I purchased. It comes with 8 mattes and 4 metallics. So if you are a matte eyeshadow fan, you definitely get the most mattes in this palette. The actual packaging is my least favorite. It kind of comes in like this off-white packaging that gets very dirty very quickly, and it's not super easy to clean. Like a makeup wipe doesn't generally take the eyeshadow off, so I don't love the packaging. I just feel like it's kind of plain. It gets really dirty, especially because the shadows in here are very, you know, pigmented, so they get all over the place, and I'm pretty careful with my palettes. So anyways, this palette is very warm toned. If you're not a warm eyeshadow fan, you are not going to want to buy this one. You will not reach for it. In general, you're going to get a very warm eye look out of it, and more often than not, it's going to be very orange, very red, very gold. So if you're not a fan of those type of eye looks, skip this one. It will not work well for you. If you are a fan of warm palettes, if you like Urban Decay's Naked Heat or the Anastasia Modern Renaissance or the Sweet Peach palette, then this palette might be the one for you. I won't say that there are any like super obvious dupes in this palette compared to some of the higher end palettes that I just mentioned, but a lot of people do compare it to the Natasha Denona Sunset palette. I don't have that palette in my collection, but a lot of people say that this is a great affordable alternative to that palette. I really like warm shadows, but to be honest with you guys, I feel like I reach for this palette the least out of all of them. I don't know if it's just because I have a lot of warm palettes in my collection that I use more than this one, but I feel like the warm shadows in this palette are very bold. So you're not necessarily going to get like an everyday look or even like a subtle warm look. You're going to get a very bold, very warm eyeshadow look. And that hasn't really been something that I've been going for a ton lately. I mean, of course, I'm wearing like a pretty bold look today, but in terms of like oranges and reds, I don't think I've been wearing a whole lot of those colors lately. I will wear them on occasion, but I usually reach for more like pink tones. So I think the quality of this palette is amazing. I love the fact that there are 8 matte shadows, because you know the other palettes tend to focus more so on metallics, and I love metallics, but I think that this is a great way to try out the ColourPop matte shadow formula in case you've been wanting to try it. They cannot keep this palette in stock though, so if it appeals to you and it's in stock when you're on the website, I would recommend grabbing it. They're going to keep restocking it until you can essentially get it when you want to get it, but it's always out of stock. So if you do want it, or you think you'll be using it sooner rather than later, I would recommend grabbing it. So I did do a full review on this palette, so I'll just kind of go over it briefly, but this one is the ColourPop My Little Pony Eyeshadow Palette. So again, this one is limited edition. I don't know if it's sold out on the website right now, but I did hear that they are restocking it, but it's limited edition, so it won't be around forever. So this one comes with 4 mattes, 6 metallics, and 2 shimmers. This one is more of a colorful palette, but I still feel like it makes makes color a little bit more wearable. I don't feel like it's too intimidating. So if you are a fan of colorful shadows, I think you might like this one. But also if you don't wear a whole lot of color on your eyes, but you want to get a little bit more into colorful shadows, this might be a great option for you because I feel like it makes color a little bit more wearable. Don't get me wrong, there are some really bold, bright, colorful shadows in this palette, but you can always kind of pair them with neutrals to tone it down. Or of course you can go all out and wear color all over your eyes. I like the matte shadows in this palette. I think they're really beautiful. This white matte actually has like this pink iridescence to it, so it's not a completely white matte shadow, but it's absolutely beautiful as a highlight color. I like that the bottom kind of focuses on blues and greens. I feel like it's a little bit different, and there are some great pinks in here, a really gorgeous purple that I can't stop wearing. In general, I think it's a really fun palette. I think I've been reaching for it a lot more than I thought I would because I think, again, it makes color a little bit more wearable. The colorful shadows aren't super intimidating, so a lot of times I'll reach for one of my other palettes and blend browns into the crease, and then I'll go in with one of these colors on the lid, and I think it looks really gorgeous. Of course, you can create some really pretty eye looks using this palette. There are some good mattes that work well in the crease and, you know, the outer corner and the brow bone, and then you can go in with the other shadows on the lid, and I think you can get some really seamless eye looks. There are two shadows in here that aren't my favorite. This one right here is in a satin finish, and the satin finish is just not my favorite. It's a little bit more subtle, and then this shadow right here is almost a little bit chunky. It's a little bit glittery, so I don't really find that it applies, you know, the best on my eyes. But I definitely wouldn't call them unwearable. So in general, it's a really beautiful palette. I think if you are a fan of color, you'll like it. And even if you're not necessarily the biggest colorful eyeshadow fan, but you've been wanting to incorporate more color, I think that you'll really like this one as well. If I personally had to rank them in terms of the shadows that I would keep in my collection and use the most often, I would choose the I Think I Love You palette first. I think it just has the most wearable colors, and these are kind of like my favorite shades. The second one that I would pick is the She palette because I feel like it's a little bit more unique and you get that color, but you still kind of get that neutral aspect to it, if that makes sense. Then I would choose the My Little Pony palette because I think it is a fun addition to your collection, especially if you already have, you know, a matte shadow palette in your collection that you really enjoy that's more neutral. This one is a nice addition. And then lastly, I would choose the Yes Please palette. I just don't find myself reaching for this one as much as I want to because the shadows are so bold, and I usually go for, you know, a little bit more of a subdued look, even if I go for a pretty warm eye. So those are my final thoughts on the ColourPop Pressed Powder Shadow Palettes. I hope this video was helpful. I realize that it's a little bit overdue because a lot of these palettes have been available for a while, but I still wanted to share my opinions and my thoughts on them. Anytime they release a new palette, I'm going to grab it. I think the formula is good. $16 is honestly a steal in my opinion. And I like that they create so many like fun on-trend colors. I think they're a little bit different than your typical palettes that you see, you know, in stores because they always have some kind of fun element to them. I think they are really fun to mix and match as well. They're great for travel because they're super small, they're really slim, and you can just throw them in your makeup bag. And if you have multiple palettes, it's really fun to go into multiple palettes when you're doing your eyeshadow look because there are some fun colors that kind of coordinate well between the palettes. So those are my thoughts. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you let me know in the comments below which palette is your favorite because I would love to hear from you, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.